6 failed terrorist plots. Before we start, I would like you to hit that red subscribe button so that you never miss out on any of our videos. Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to Crime Junkies. 6. Anti-Semitic terrorism. With the immense amount of diversity present in New York City, it only seems fitting that someone looking to attack people with specific beliefs would choose the metropolis for their plot. That is what happened in 2009, when 4 men thought they could bomb some local synagogues and get away with it. 6. It was thankfully busted when an undercover agent infiltrated a local mosque where these men belonged and continued to hatch their devious plan. As the men attempted to purchase their supplies, they were led into a trap by the undercover agent and were ultimately arrested. The 4 conspirators, David Williams, Anta Williams, Laguerre Payen, and James Cromedy, were each sentenced to 25 years in prison. 5. Nuruddin M. Abdi. U.S. government agencies such as the FBI, NSA, and CIA all work tirelessly to ensure that innocent American lives are preserved and that the general public does not have to worry about being attacked every day. In the case of Nuruddin M. Abdi, these agencies did just that and prevented this man from planting and exploding a bomb inside an Ohio shopping mall. Nuruddin is a Somali national who had gone to various parts of Africa to obtain the training and skills needed to carry out an attack that would have left hundreds dead or injured. Linked to Al-Qaeda, he received instructions on how to manufacture explosives and worked with 2 co-conspirators who lived in Ohio. According to Department of Justice documents, Nuruddin made many false statements and claims about entering and leaving the country, which aroused suspicion and prompted the government to keep a watch on him. 4. Assault on Fort Dix. The soldiers of the United States worked to fight enemies, both foreign and domestic, and with this failed plot, terrorists attempt to bring the violence right to the American home front. In 2007, 6 men were arrested in connection to a plan to use assault rifles and grenades to attack American soldiers at Fort Dix in New Jersey. The plot was uncovered when the group attempted to have a videotape, which contained scenes of them shouting and waving guns above their heads, converted to DVD. After a thorough investigation and infiltration by an undercover agent, it was uncovered that the men had been on a training mission in the Pocono Mountains and were equipped to carry out their planned attack. 3. Richard Reed. After the terrorist attacks on September 11, 2001, the US was on high alert. One might think it would have been a bad time to try another attack, but Richard Reed was not that one. Just months after September 11th, he thought he would be able to swiftly take down a plane from Paris to Miami in mid-flight. Reed, who was later connected to Al-Qaeda, became known as the shoe bomber when he attempted to detonate an explosive device he had secretly hidden in his shoes. Reed was able to pack enough explosives into his footwear to destroy a commercial airliner. Luckily, the plan was thwarted when he was unable to light a match that was needed to ignite the explosive. A few minutes later, he got the match lit, but the shoe bombs were useless from how sweaty his feet were. 2. Hazzam Smadi. The FBI is there to protect the American people from threats against them, and this failed terrorist plot exemplifies their hard work. Hazzam Smadi was the subject of a 10-month-long investigation which resulted in his arrest and sentencing to 24 years in prison. He was noticed when he began posting worrisome writings on a known website for radical Islamists in 2009. His visa from Jordan expired, which raised more red flags. The FBI began to surveil Smadi, and 3 agents began communicating with him, leading Smadi to believe he'd found an Al-Qaeda sleeper cell. Smadi was ultimately supplied with a fake bomb, which he intended to use to blow up the Fountain Place skyscraper in Dallas. He drove the bomb under the building and tried to use a cell phone to detonate it. Obviously, nothing happened. Smadi was promptly arrested. 1. Al-Qaeda plans to attack the U.S. Navy. While most terrorist attacks are thought to be on land or focused on buildings, the attack on the U.S. Navy vessel USS The Sullivan shows that terrorists will attack anywhere that will instill fear. In January 2000, a group of Al-Qaeda terrorists planned to attack the USS The Sullivans, which was docked at Aden, Yemen. Their plan was to load a smaller boat full of explosives, simply drive it up next to the ship, and detonate it. Unsurprisingly, this simplistic plan was not fully thought through. After the boat was loaded with the explosives, it immediately sank. This brings us to the end of our video. I hope you enjoyed it. hit like if you did, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel so that you don't miss any of our videos in the future. Also, watch the two videos that are on your screen, because I'm sure you'll love them.